Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to Watch One, and thanks for logging on. Well, it's Memorial Day, and I'm here with Federico for the Memorial Day 500. Fed, we're in pole position to pick our favorite sub-$500 watches.
You know what? This really wasn't easy. A lot of you guys may think, you know, are there really that many options? The truth is, there are.
We can have fun with five, and we're doing it live. Okay, record it.
Oh, Fed, God, puns.
The pace car starts us out. Fed, be the pace car. Tell me, where does this go?
Well, you can do any. You can go from modern to vintage, right? And there's a whole lot of choices. But I'm gonna go with my favorite modern sub-$500 watch.
Okay.
And it's very sub-$500. It's probably closer to 200.
Okay.
And I'm wearing it right now. It is my Seiko SKX 009. Pepsi. 009 or 007? Well, one is the black and one is the Pepsi. It's got the in-house Seiko movement. It's non-hacking and non-manual wind, so very basic, but it looks great. It's an ISO-certified diver, and you can beat the crap out of it.
And at below $200, you're keeping something in the tank for later. Fed on a fuel saver strategy, far below 500 on that pick. Okay, I'm going to make everyone angry, especially you.
Oh, please.
With my first pick, which is one from back in the day, the 1968, going with the Seiko myself here, Skyliner, reference 6220-7990. Folks, the world of tomorrow today on your wrist, 21 jewels manual winding, and oh so 60s optimistic.
You know what? I didn't know this watch until you just showed it to me before we shot. I love your taste in watches, but Tim, on this one, you're on your own, buddy. Like, this is not for me.
This is the kind of watch I would wear on the veranda deck of the nuclear passenger slash cargo ship Savannah, circa 1968, soaking up the rays, both UV and gamma.
It's got that look. It almost looks, I mean, it's a very Mad Men-esque watch. It's very simplified, but it's got those funky lines. I love the manual wind movement. I mean, I can understand why you picked it.
Yes.
And I'd love to own one, but it'd be the typical watch, kind of like my Timex Illuminator, that I want in my collection, but I probably would never wear, but I want it in my watch box.
It's a period piece, to be sure, just as lozenge-shaped, lugless watches are the thing for the 70s. There are some weirdly 60s watches. The Omega Dynamic is one, the Skyliner is another. Again, the world of tomorrow today, I'm a madman, I get it. Emphasis on the mad. Fed, where do we go next?
Well, actually, you preempted me. I think another great value in vintage, sub-500, and guys, you can find them for a lot more, but trust me, it can be had sub-500, is the Omega Dynamic Bullseye. If I could have my particular pick, it would be with the blue and gray dial and the blue racing strap.
Okay.
You know, it's an in-house, it is an in-house Omega movement.
Yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
It's an in-house Omega movement. There's a day-date variant, which is very hard to pick.
I'm a fan.
Loves.
That and one you probably can't get below 500.
This UFO-shaped case, it's dressy, yet it's sporty. It's a period piece, and it's still correctly sized to fit my wrist in 2017.
Yeah, it seems like every era has its oval-shaped watch, and for the late 60s, early 70s, the Omega Dynamic was that watch.
Absolutely, and actually there's a ton of variants. There's the Omega Dynamic, the Dynamic DeVille, the Chronostop, while not technically a dynamic, is the same shape. Yes.
Those have now been priced out of the sub-500 range, so we're going to veer a little bit off course and get back on track for the Memorial Day 500. Fed, I'm going to come back with a watch from that same period that's so weird. Honestly, I don't know that I can really relate it in any terms, except it could be called the father of the Swatch. This is the Tissot Astralon Actualis, the caliber 2280 with the day-date. This was a 52-part plastic movement, and I mean all plastic, self-lubricating one jewel. The whole idea was that it could be constructed from injection-molded components, mostly by robots.
You know what I think? You know how, remember the jewel race that happened in like the 80s, I think, where people were like trying to shove as many jewels in a movement as possible?
Yeah, also the early 20th century, they would just put tons of jewels on the plate and just say, 100 jewels.
I find it more impressive when it's one jewel. I mean, that's impressive to me.
And the amazing thing to me is that these plastic watches are still running more than 40 years later. So, hey, Tissot Astrolon, like I said, 2280 is the day-date. I think that's cool. But you can also get it in plain and with a single date. The fact that they're still around and available for under $500, that's how you go vintage on a budget and have a great time doing it.
Old school System 51 type feeling, huh?
Yes, very much so.
I guess for me, I'm going to do one more, well, a couple more vintage, but the easy choice, because it could be had for well under $500, is an Omega Genève, which I'm not going to, well, I just did mention it, but I'm going to go for a slightly more interesting, in my mind, model, a vintage Gerard Perregaux Seahawk, the dress version. They can be had in steel or even the rare chrome-plated case, which I didn't know.
Chrome plate, we're going there.
Gerard Perregaux. I didn't know Gerard Perregaux did that, but indeed they did. You know, you can get a nice 34 to 36 millimeter dress watch. They come in automatic and manual wind, and they can be had for as low as $300. I mean, $500 will get you a pretty nice Seahawk.
You know, it's important to note there are a lot of vintage watches still available below $500. Just cruising the blogs and the auction sites, you'd think every vintage watch was worth a mint. The fact is, the vast majority out there are just old watches available cheap. Find something interesting. You can have a ton of fun.
It may take a little while because you have to sift through watches you don't like, redials, stuff you're just not interested in. But, you know, trust me, you spend a few hours on eBay with a $500 budget, you can come out with a fistful of pretty cool watches.
And speaking of a fistful of fun, you can get a Longines Ultrachron from those same swinging 60s, caliber 430, 431, 432. If you want a high beat El Primero style double step cadence, Longines, right about 1967, coming out with the Ultrachron, their answer to the Gerard Perregaux high frequency. This was the era just before quartz when it was thought that the next logical step was going to be a high beat mechanical movement. You get something with potentially superb accuracy, a lot of horological value. You can get them for very little money, as they're still available for maybe $200, $300 in some cases, and then you've got a true mechanical movement that can be serviced again and again and kept for life. Again, for well under $500, I'm sitting on my nuclear ship once again, soaking up the sun.
Even though I've heard, and please correct me if I'm wrong, I almost bought an Ultrachron. I've heard that they may not be the easiest thing to service. Can you speak on that at all?
Yeah, a little bit. Obviously, it's a delicate movement. It's not huge, it's not thick, and you need special lubricants to work on the escapement. Basically, just the kind of watchmaker who would work on a JLC 889 or Zenith El Primero should know exactly what he's doing. The guy who's only ever had his hands on a 2892, 2824, and a 6497, avoid that guy.
Fair enough. And actually, I'm going to go with my last pick, one that I bought myself from a now defunct, well, actually they came back, but in name only.
Sure.
An Atlantic Worldmaster, a vintage Atlantic Worldmaster from the 50s. Now, the one I bought, I'm going to put a picture right up here, is a 36 millimeter watch with an ETA movement. And this is, you know, ETA Priest watch group.
Yeah.
So very cool. At a movement with a red-tipped second hand, a little bit of patina on the dial. And you know what, Tim? I found this. I mean, they trade around $300. A little bit of luck, I found it for $45.
Yeah, you can find some incredible things if you're willing to go after esoterica. And trust me, you'll find it just as interesting after you get into these watches. Once you absorb yourself in the world of them, they become as cool as Rolex. They become as cool as vintage
and,
AP.
And let me tell you,
Omega.
When you look at this Worldmaster, Tim, and you see the Worldmaster name in the script, the red tip secondhand, this is one of those watches where, you know, if the blogosphere picked it up, could easily be trading for $1,500 in 2 years for no reason. You know what I mean?
For no reason other than hype. Get it while it's not hyped.
You know, and hopefully, there's no distinguishing, you know, a watch like that to some of these other super hyped, you know.
I mean, they're all old watches. What we all agree is cool is suddenly cool. So decide for yourself that something different is cool in advance, and you'll be happy for it. Now, Again, we're going at just a race car pace today. After a quick pick stop, I have reconsidered, and in the closing laps, I'm going to pick what might be my favorite of all of the vintagey sub-$500 watches I'm recommending today, and that is the Bulova Accutron Caliber 218 Day-Date family. Many options. You got to remember, the Accutrons, the tuning fork watches, built from about 1960 to 1978, the ones that aren't called Astronaut, Railroad, or Space View are still available super cheap. You can get a functional example under $100. And with the 218 Day-Date, you have a very usable complication, a historic movement that sounds just as cool up against the ear as the 214 Space Views and the rest of them. This is a watch with a lot of historic value, horological value, serviceability, and again, with a Day-Date, I love that kind of complication. Three of the watches I've picked have been Day-Dates today.
Sure. Let me tell you, Tim, tuning forks, they're just cool.
They're
just so cool.
They are. And you got to remember, most Accutrons built were not Space Views, but all of the historic Accutrons were tuning forks.
And the current that's being sold right now, Accutron Space View, is not a tuning fork. What's up with that?
Oh, what's up with that? Branding is what's up with that.
I mean, to me, that's blasphemy, almost.
That's playing a cute fuel strategy, and we're not into it this Memorial Day 500. What we are into is fun for not a lot of money.
Yeah.
So if you want to field a winning effort for under 500, I don't think you can do any better than the Swatch System Green. That's a personal preference.
I own the System Blue myself. And actually, another quick little shout out, my favorite modern field watch is under $500, the Hamilton Khaki King, another great, great watch with an ETA 2824, an ETA 2836 in the King model, or the Powermatic 80 if you go with the modern version.
So it's a photo finish. Honestly, we've got so many awesome options below $500 for you this Memorial Day. It's more than enough to keep you active on the Fora and eBay till well into tomorrow morning. With that said, Fed, sign us off.
Guys, thank you so much for sticking around with us, and we will be back tomorrow with Federico Talks Watches and live with Mike Michaels on Wednesday. Right, Tim?
That's correct. Mike Michaels is back Wednesday for Wednesday with the Watchmaker. Forward your questions to Federico at WatchYouWant.
Thank you so much, guys, and we'll catch you in the next one.
That's the finish line, the milk, and the trophy all in one, guys. Happy Memorial Day.
Take care.